It worked. This has been great for me because you're going to see golf with clean feet. I'm more about entertaining than I am about presenting X's and O's or stuff like that. It kind of gets boring to me after a while. Maybe my age has something to do with it. Howie's obviously
the straight man.
He's our straight guy. He's our good-looking guy. He's our stud muffin. And
is he the better actor?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Have you seen Firebird?
Firestorm.
I mean, Firestorm. One of the classics.
The great thing about working here is I don't think anyone's ever said in 26 years, do this or say this.
It's not structured.
You're
like
you
that.
And I'm me. And,
right.
And the only thing they want is they want it to be kind of lighthearted and more
entertaining. Kind
of entertaining and conversational.
Right.
People never say to us on a Wednesday, hey, I love that football point you made.
It's they're always, going in and
it's
out,
always
the
two-man
combo.
It's always the laugh or the gaff or when somebody screws
up. I had a gaff today.
No.
He's back, which only makes
Khalil Mack.
Yeah. Much more dangerous.
Hey,
wasn't he like one of the god of strength?
Yeah.
And if you think Terry is some sort of country bumpkin, well, Howie's got news for you.
I tell people all the time, he has rode that Jed Clampett Beverly Hillbillies thing all the way to the bank. You have bought it hook, line, and sinker. Trust me.
Trust me. No, you hear me loud and clear. See, everybody thinks because I act the way I act that I'm really smart. But that's really just who I am. I'm just a simple guy.
He's one of the smartest people I know.
The show feels unscripted. That's because it is. There's no prompter.
No. Read a prompter?
Well, first of all, we can't read.
No, that's a problem.
You said that.
That's a problem.
When Super Bowl Sunday rolls around,
we always talk about defense in the playoffs.
Do these guys approach that big game any differently?
It is not about necessarily the pregame show and the material we have as it is about Fox showcasing its talent and its production capabilities throughout the entire football world and presenting it to the American audience and around the world. And we're proud of that. I find the Super Bowl to be very easy to do.
This is our ninth Super Bowl. And, you know, I think about the one we did down in New Orleans right after 9/11, which was pretty amazing. And, you know, U2 does halftime, and behind them playing Streets Have No Names, which essentially is a huge sheet with all the names of the folks who were lost in 9/11. And it was one of the most amazing moments. And the theme for us in that pregame was the Constitution, you know, and revisiting the founding fathers and what makes this country special. And it was all about America. And I remember Terry, the last thing he said, because we looked at St. Louis and New England over and over and over again. There was no way on God's green earth we said New England could beat them. I said, this team is just too good. And Terry, as he always does, as we're getting ready to go on the air, he makes his final pick and says, in a year like this, what this country's been through, how can't you pick the Patriots? And I'm like, are you kidding me? You picked the Patriots, and the Patriots end up winning.